Coming up on today's show, we take a look at recent updates for information protection and management of OneDrive for Business, from limiting syncing to domain join machines that you manage, to additional controls to govern the scope of file sharing, and updates to mobile device management and how you can protect the flow of data from OneDrive. Keep watching as we'll check back in on the OneDrive for Business roadmap. Joined again by Ruben Krippner. Welcome.
Thanks for having me.
So there's been a lot of updates for OneDrive for Business. Why don't you walk us through a few of those?
Sure. So let's start with something that's been commonly requested from IT, and that's the ability to block sync on non-domain joined or unmanaged PCs. So the typical scenario from IT is that they want to restrict sync on personal home computers or on PCs that are on domains that they don't want sync to be applied, maybe R&D, maybe the legal team. So it's important to note also that this particular feature will automatically block all Mac sync simply because they can't be truly domain joined.
So this is a really good option if you don't want to have corporate data find its way onto unmanaged computers, but how does it work?
So initially we'll be providing this by a PowerShell commandlet, and it's really, really simple. So firstly, what you do is you identify the domain GUIDs of the domains that you want to allow sync to occur on. And then it's simply the case on running this PowerShell command, and very, very simple to set up. So if you have a look at the commandlet here, it's set SBO tenant sync client restriction. I can then set the parameter of enable, and then all I need is a semicolon delimited list of the domain GUIDs. Once that's actually run, then what's going to happen is that sync is only enabled on those domain joined PCs. So in this case, let's have a look at the end user experience. And so if the user goes in with that setting, they're on either a home PC or a blocked domain. When they actually run sync, what will actually happen is it will go through the standard sync process, will connect to the actual server. But what happens when they actually click on sync now is it will prompt them and say, hey, we couldn't sync this library. You're not able to take this offline. So it's very clear for the end user there's no way to take these files offline.
A lot of great stuff there in terms of managing, again, unmanaged or personally owned PCs from syncing. Again, this won't work on a Mac computer as well. Let me show you, though, something. You talked about domain GUIDs, and I know a lot of people might not be aware of how I can actually get that value. So I have here on my computer the method of getting the domain GUID. It's also via PowerShell. So in this case, I'm checking my domain, getting my AD forest, looking for each of those, which identity in terms of domain GUIDs I have available to me. In my case, I have just one object GUID that gets displayed. Now, that's the value that we're going to pipe into your domain GUID value that you showed earlier. But we have even more to show in terms of OneDrive for Business, right?
That's right. So on top of that, with all of this ability to control and restrict sync on domain or managed PCs, we can also have a look at the new auditing and reporting capabilities in Compliance Center, and I can actually go and filter on actions such as those computers that were blocked or those computers that were allowed. And so when I actually run that report, you'll see here's a list of all of the requests, the sync requests that have been blocked, and I've got information like the client IP. So I could actually follow up with that user, maybe give them some more coaching or training about how they can actually sync their content offline on a managed PC.
Great, so lots of great reporting, but beyond just what we can do on the desktops, a lot of great updates that we're doing in terms of mobile devices. So if I think about it, a lot of people are just connecting to data through email, but as that progresses into OneDrive for Business, I want to be able to protect that traffic as well. And one of the great things that we have now in Office 365 is the ability to enroll mobile devices straight into MDM, even if they're only attached via OneDrive for Business. So I just wanted to flip over to my computer here, and we'll see that I've got a couple of machines joined. I have even a Windows 10 PC joined, as well as the iPhone and a Samsung Android phone. So all of these are here, and you'll notice that I've also got the ability to either do a full wipe like we're used to from the Exchange Active Sync side, or a selective wipe. So let me show you what I've got on my phone itself, because what I want to show you is how the selective wipe actually works, because I can get rid of even OneDrive for Business content on that device now, not just the Exchange content. So I'm going to fire up my phone, and we'll see that if I open up OneDrive first, it's managed by my company, so we see that straight away. If I go into my accounts, I have both my personal account as well as my Contoso Office 365 account. Now, if I go back to my computer, I'm going to issue that selective wipe. Now, again, this computer only has, or this phone, I should say, only has OneDrive for Business set up on it, not anything with email. I'm going to go ahead and click selective wipe. It will give me a warning. All right, so now if I pick up my phone again, you'll see that the accounts here are actually going to perform a wipe against my phone, and my company then has removed access, in this case, to OneDrive for me, leaving my my personal data on the device and my personal OneDrive data intact, but basically resetting that application so it doesn't have any of the corporate data on my phone. So really cool stuff there in terms of managing not just email, but also OneDrive on the mobile device.
And of course, with the offline capabilities coming to the mobile apps before the end of this year, it will not only be about blocking app access, but also being able to remove corporate files as well.
Right, so what other controls do we have to really limit the flow of data on devices?
So another option that we're providing is to limit the amount of storage that each user can have on OneDrive for Business. And again, so this is based on a very simple PowerShell commandlet, and I can go in and set for individual users a particular storage quota. So in this particular case, what I'm going to go and do is set the limit from 1 terabyte down to 500 gigabytes. So all I need to do is set SPO site, set the identity or the URL of the site, mm-hmm. and then we've got this parameter storage quota. So that's in megabytes, 512,000 megabytes. So when I actually go and run that, it will apply that onto the site. And what we'll see when we actually go into the site itself, when I look at the storage metrics for that particular site, we'll see now there it is set to 500 gigabytes. So just another mechanism at IT's disposal to help limit the flow or the ability to manipulate or use corporate files maliciously.
So a lot of people have also been requesting additional controls around limiting the scope of file sharing.
That's right. So we've been finding that many users, rather than specifically nominating who they want to share files with, are simply dragging files into the Shared with Everyone folder, makes them universally discoverable and can cause a challenge for IT and control about the scope of file sharing. So what we're actually doing is we're bringing in some controls that allows IT to force the user to nominate who they specifically want to share that with. And again, we're doing that via a PowerShell commandlet. So in this case, we want to be able to turn off the show everyone. We want to be able to turn off everyone except external users and all users. So basically limiting all of the means to share with everyone. On top of that, what we're also doing is by default, the Shared with Everyone folder won't be provisioned for all new tenants and all new users. You can enable that if you want to. So we're really allowing IT to control that. So let's show you this commandlet. All I need to do is, in this case, I'm turning off the everyone claim, and I just set that to false. Really, really simple. So now when I actually go back to the user experience, let's say that I want to go and share this particular file. Standard share dialog here. And as I type in everyone, ordinarily that would resolve. You'll see in this case we haven't turned off the everyone except external users, but I can go and do that as well. So really limiting the flow and the scope of sharing to have more control over that.
So you can also turn off the all users item from the people picker as well.
That's right.
And these are some really great features and capabilities a lot of people have been asking for to manage OneDrive for Business, but there's a lot of new additional stuff coming this year as well, right?
That's right. So at Ignite, we obviously made some big announcements, and we can confirm we're on track as far as the next-gen sync, the new sync client coming out before the end of the calendar year. We'll also, as we talked about, add offline support to our mobile apps. We've got a complete web client refresh, which I'll be really excited to talk about the next time we're together. And finally, a bunch of enterprise IT features, including the ability to set an allow or deny list of domains that users can share with externally. So lots of really exciting stuff coming, and all before the end of this calendar year.
So all the IT management controls around limiting file sync to domain join PCs and the MDM capabilities are available today, and you can start using those right now. Also, keep checking back to the Office blog and Office Mechanics on Wednesdays or as news hits. Thank you all for watching, and goodbye for now.